Entirely untouched nature has become a rare sight. Because thanks to modern technology, humankind was able to change the face of our planet completely. We now produce our stuff in massive factories on the other side of the world, we live in sprawling cities and dig our resources out of gigantic pit mines. Such artificial places are as far away from nature as you can imagine. It is easy to tell that they were created by humans. Although cities all over the world continue to expand, they are not even close to cover the whole planet. So if we want to find pristine nature, we just have to leave the crowded places far enough behind us, right? Let's look at Ireland, for example. The Green Island is so sparsely populated that some counties like Donegal only reach population densities of around 30 people per square kilometer. And even though everything here, except for the tourists, looks perfectly natural, something is missing. About 6,000 years ago, dense oak, elm and alder forests covered most of Ireland. From then on, humanity quickly conquered the island. They chopped away the forests to produce firewood, make room for agriculture and build ships as well as houses. Deforestation continued until the end of the 19th century, when only 1% of forest cover was left. Nowadays, thanks to state-funded reforestation efforts, Irish woodland area is at around 10% again. However, those newly planted forests have little in common with the now lost primeval forests. Similar developments have taken place in almost all inhabited areas of the world. Through centuries of extensive use, humans turned most untouched natural landscapes into so-called cultural landscapes. Only a few places have been spared from this process, and until now, we have even spared an entire continent. Antarctica. Although there are many research stations and even two tiny permanent settlements with their own schools and hospitals located here, it is safe to say that the human influence on the eternal ice is rather limited. In 1959, the international community agreed with the signing of the Antarctic Treaty on the exclusively peaceful and primarily scientific use of the southern continent. Since an explicit mining ban and a comprehensive environmental protection system were added to this treaty in 1991, Antarctica is now considered the largest nature reserve on Earth. With its area of 14.2 million square kilometers, it's roughly twice the size of the contiguous United States. In order to find the last of the wilds in the rest of the world, we have to look at a metric called the human footprint. The human footprint measures the land-based influence of human activity on the environment by recording the distribution of anthropogenic nature disturbances. Scientists from the universities of Amsterdam and Queensland analyzed global data on the built environment, agricultural land use, road and rail infrastructure, population density, as well as waterway usage and nighttime light pollution to map the human footprint for the world's entire land area. And even though this dataset is from 2009, this is the most up-to-date view of the worldwide human footprint we currently have. The researchers then used the resulting map to identify the remaining so-called pressure-free lands. These are all contiguous areas that are larger than 10,000 square kilometers and have a human footprint of zero, which basically means they are completely free of human influence. Let's see where they are, shall we? At a first glance, you notice that the last untouched natural areas are also located where hardly any people are living anyway, either due to the climate or the topography. This is why the Arctic regions, the Himalayas, the Sahara and the Australian outback are home to the largest still undisturbed ecosystems on the planet. What surprised me, however, are the big rainforest regions in Africa and South America. I surely was aware that the rainforests in West and Central Africa have long suffered from the extreme population growth, armed conflicts and political instability in these regions. But I never thought that today not a single pressure-free area of tropical rainforest is left on this continent. Meanwhile, the untouched regions in the Amazon rainforest are being reduced to increasingly smaller patches. This process started in the 1970s, when Brazil built the Trans-Amazonian Highway to promote settlement and economic growth in the at that time still untapped rainforest. If we compare the extent of the rainforest ecoregions in South America with the pressure-free lands here, it quickly shows how far the human influence already reaches. Today, the Amazon rainforest is crisscrossed by roads and busy waterways, and the constant clear-cutting creates space for growing settlements, more farmland and pasture. Worldwide, around 22% of the Earth's land surface are left untouched by humans. And those areas are getting smaller every year. From 1993 to 2009, we lost more than 2 million square kilometers of unspoiled nature. That's roughly the size of Alaska and Texas combined. Considering that this data is already 11 years old, probably even more land has been lost. On top of that, things like poaching, small-scale logging, invasive species and pollution are not even included in this map. So this is actually a pretty optimistic view. And one more thing is missing. The increasing concentration of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere and the resulting warming of the planet. A process we now call climate change, and which an overwhelming majority of climate experts attribute to human activities. In theory, rising levels for greenhouse gases such as CO2 can be measured anywhere in the world, which means that today literally no place on Earth could be classified as free from human influence.